Hello, Mr. Bizarre, here, back with another DIY thing again. Eventually I'll get that intro to roll off the tongue, but anyway, as you can tell, I'm back outside, and yes, this is going to be another solar-related discussion, even though I have to be kind of honest, it's raining. I'm going to go inside in a moment, but anyway, this is more of a update video, and also my thoughts on, at least, small-grade solar stuff, as let's be fair. That's kind of one thing I've been trying to do, is be a bit more eco, I suppose, and I'm just going to get inside first, because rain, and I do not wish to get rained upon. Anyway, now, as you've known, that solar panel is for the solar system, or at least my, solar garden lights, which are actually dotted around, because quite a few things have changed, in all honesty. I no longer have those, you know, really silly light sticks, as you can sort of see in the distance there, if I zoom in. I do actually have, where's a better one? There it is. I actually do have proper solar lights, or at least that's what they physically look like, but they are all wired essentially into the system. Not only have I done that, I've also given it a lot more power, and I will, I'll get to that in a second, because I think the first thing, I think the biggest elephant in the room is I upgraded the actual power supply. Now, yes, even though that's meant to be standing up, and it isn't, it's actually lying down, that is mostly because the glue attaching this, the hot glue, is kind of giving up. So I've just put it on its back. And yes, there are wires everywhere. I'll get to these two things in a minute. But I've got to be honest, I have actually been, at least recently, I have enough power coming in and storage that I can pretty much just run all my my portable devices like phones, power banks. I'm actually able to run these, or at least charge them up solely now, off of solar energy, which is certainly a step in the right direction. Even though I kind of need more solar power, because in terms of the power supply, not only have I actually, that's the same lead acid battery I started with previously, that you've already seen in the last video if you watched that. But I've neatened up the cable there. I did a much better job, at least giving it an XT60 in this instance, and just it looks a lot neater. And this is going to probably throw some people up in the comments. Throw some people up, making me sound like I'm going to make you guys vomit. I don't know, but the extra battery I have utilized this time is that big fucker down there. Yes, that is an actual car battery, a 45 amp hour unit. That. If I could get the phone down there, because I can't really lean down there, but you can sort of see it there. Sorry for the bad camera angle, but I cannot fit in the gap behind the seat there. Now, people have said that car batteries are not exactly a good choice because you really need deep cycle batteries, and there's actually a bunch of other reasons for it. Now, in my opinion, and this is going to be my obnoxious opinion, then, you know, some people are going to disagree with me. If you disagree with me and you want to give me a spiel of technical information, then I'll certainly listen and, you know, just put that in the comments and all of that. But honestly, in terms of a battery like this, it's lead acid, right? Lead acid is pretty much the same, regardless of what battery it is, whether it's a car battery, deep cycle, pretty much. The actual physical construction inside the battery is different. I am well aware of this. Now, car batteries are meant for short, sharp bursts of really high current, which is meant for your starter motor, which I get, you know, I get that's what they do. But in all honesty, though, if you're just sipping essentially very small amounts of power, because let's be honest, those lights through the buck converters and all that, like the lights out there, they're not going to consume much power at all. I think the whole light setup probably draws less than half an amp, if that. Actually, that's getting a bit... It's actually a bit high, maybe about 300 milliamps in total. So there's really not a lot of power going out. And okay, if I have the USB output, then, you know, that's 5 volts at 2 amps. But just because that's 5 volts, 2 amps on the output, the input from the battery side is going to be a hell of a lot less. So there is that. So the battery itself is mostly just there for storage. And that's probably one of the main reasons why I think a battery, yes, of the car variety. And I will definitely try and get some actual proper terminals for the wires rather than just use those jumper clips that I had lying around, but you get the point. But just sipping power off of that battery is mostly what it does. And the other battery there is in parallel, so there is that. So in total, since that's 45 amp hours, I've got about 52 amp hours of battery capacity at my disposal, which, in all honesty, even on really shit days like this, at the moment, I've actually yet to drain this thing below 12 volts, you can see there, even though this is still one of those really crappy PWM controllers, We're at 12.3 right now. Let's just say a full day of sun. I've seen that battery go only as high as about 12.6, 12.7 volts. And in the morning, I wake up to find it has gone down, although I think that's mostly the voltage just going back down on its own accord because the input goes away at night, obviously, because the sun's not there. But I've seen that thing go down to about 12.3 volts somewhere in there, which is actually pretty much where we're at right now, because as you would kind of expect, we're not getting much sun because it's fucking pissing it down with rain. Now, as you would also expect from such a huge battery, that solar panel, and I like the camera's just going to focus on this stupid chain, the actual panel itself is definitely not, how would we put it? There's not a lot of power, even under full sun, to charge that thing in a single day. Hell, if that small battery took about a day and a half of full, uninterrupted sunshine, at least in the English summer, which, English summer, in quotation marks, you know, if that took 1.5 days to charge 7 amp hour, that would probably take about a week. So getting more panels is on my list of things to do, but to be honest, the garden, even though camera likes to focus on the raindrops, that's good to know, but the garden itself is actually kind of small. I think you could pretty much just see that just by looking at it. The garden is pretty tiny. Now, I can't really wire this place up to the nth degree because my parents, well, let's just say my dad, even though I didn't, like, normally I don't tell what my I don't tell my parents if I'm doing random things, because, like, fucking hell, I'm 22, I don't need to tell them everything. But dad went a little mental when he saw a fucking car battery under his seat, because parents, you know, they sit out here in the conservatory and usually get pissed. But that's a story for another day. But yeah, having a big battery there, dad wasn't too impressed, but whatever. It's probably because the fact that it's hidden, you know, behind the seat, that Dad doesn't really care as much as he could. Now, when there is sun, and you'll have to trust me on this, but as far as sun is concerned, that fence there, that exposed bit of fence anyway, it does actually get quite a bit of sun, at least up until about 1 or 2 o'clock, somewhere there. Maybe actually scratch it, maybe closer to midday, because eventually the sun tracks across the sky here. It will set about there behind that house, and it obviously rises way over there. It actually rises slightly that direction, and slightly north. We're not quite north-south facing. This garden is mostly south, but technically, if I'm facing that direction, south is actually about there. So, you know, not quite a compass-bearing house, as it were. You know, you know, we haven't got directly north and south facing, but you get the point. But in an ideal world, I'd like to put another panel on that fence there just to catch the morning sun. And I'd also like a panel, in an ideal world, on the back side of the shed roof pointing that direction. Mind you, that tree over there could grow, and actually it will grow, and probably get in the way. But, you know, I'd like to do these things, but I have to work with my parents here, because I'm still living with my parents, and I'm probably not going to move out for many years. I don't see myself actually doing such a thing. Anyway, panels aside, I did shove, as you can sort of see behind here, this is actually a small panel meant for, like, charging your car, like a trickle charge car battery thing. You plug into your, like, lighter socket, and it would obviously meant to just top up your battery when it's in the sun. You all know roughly how that works. But in this case, I think it's a 7.5 watt panel. It's nothing too crazy. But I just wired that in parallel, just to give the bigger panel up there some extra power, and it does help. It sort of gives it a little bit of a boost. And I can't lie, even though these are in parallel, I arguably should put some diodes in there, because, you know, there's actually no diodes between them, so, you know, that panel could start putting power through that panel. I mean, they probably even do that on occasion, but they are technically facing, well, they're both at 90 degrees, you know, one's on the wall there, one's over there, and they're actually facing the same direction. So, for the most part, they shouldn't really have a crazy amount of power difference between them, so, you know, energy shouldn't backflow between the panels, at least in theory. I would still obviously want more panels in time, but I will have to see what I can do there. And, you know, like I said, just for powering up my USB devices and power banks, etc., this is actually working pretty well. Now, these other couple things here, I mean, yes, that's a super cap. Now, this, if I just move that cable. Now, these are actually lithium iron phosphate batteries. This is just a small 12-volt/14.4-volt pack that I've been messing around with. Because I would, if I had, like, unlimited money, I would not really want to go with lead acid because it's big, heavy, and it doesn't last for a crazy amount of time. Although, considering the application here, these should probably last several years, if I'm being honest. Lithium iron phosphate would have been my go-to, but, well, apart from this is more of an experimental pack, the actual cost of those sort of those batteries is kind of ridiculous. To get 45 amp hours of lithium iron phosphate, I actually do have some batteries on order, which is about that capacity if I add them up. Okay, so I think it's about 70 to 80 quid if you were to go through Chinese sellers to get those cells and do all the battery, you know, pack management, you know, assembly, wiring up, put the BMS in and all the rest. And to get 45 amp hours of lead acid is just under £40. So there's quite a big difference in price versus the capacity. So that's my main reason for that, for just sticking with essentially a car battery. Not to mention, deep cycle batteries are actually kind of expensive. And I've already mentioned, this thing is going to have a very light, you know, very non-intensive life. Even though it's not actually being used for a car, it won't matter, because it's just essentially power storage. And these things, you know, in a car anyway, your car battery is going to be sat there most, you know, on charge via the engine itself pretty much all the goddamn time. So this thing would probably serve me quite well. Prove me if I'm wrong in the comments and if I'm completely missing the point of how these things work. Or, I mean, for fuck's sake, it's a lead acid battery. I somehow don't think that it's going to have any crazy amount of difference between that and deep cycle. But, you know, I get deep cycle is meant for, you know, decent amount of current for a longer period of time. These are meant for short bursts, although I think if you're just trickle charging it up essentially by that small panel and discharging it pretty slowly as well, I don't think it's going to care. Like I said, prove me if I'm wrong. Now, you know, as you're realizing how much I'm just rambling here about what I'm doing for this solar thing, and I am using it technically for solar lights at least most of the time if I'm not charging something. In all honesty, if I was to just be doing a solar system like this, actually, me just saying solar system, I can't stop thinking about the actual fucking solar system that we exist in and all the planets and shit. You get my point. I'm not talking about that solar system, but if I'm thinking just solar lights here, I would actually, you know, assuming I wasn't storing energy for other reasons, this is kind of where super caps come into play, because what I would actually do, to be fair, in the shed, that is, I put a couple of, maybe it's just a much smaller panel, and I was actually tempted to make, actually physically build a solar panel designed such to output about 3 volts, but at a really high current output. So what I'm on about, you have a bunch of these, you know, these caps. I mean, this is just a cap I got off of DigiKey, I believe. Standard supercapacitor, 2.7 volts, 400 farads. Now, what I would probably do, and this is just, like I said, this is for garden lights, have a custom panel of that sort of voltage, right? So around, let's say around 3 volts. Now, bring that into the shed. You have that through a diode so it's not feeding backwards. And more importantly, would drop the voltage by a bit. Schottky diodes, about 0.3 volts, which is perfect. 3 volts down, you know, down 0.3 is 2.7, exactly what this needs. So what you do then, you can just fit, you can have a bunch of these. I mean, let's get about 10 of these, right, in parallel. So 2.7 volts, 10 of these in parallel, that's going to be quite a few farads, what, 4,000 farads. Once you've done that, now the actual dusk to dawn thing, like the actual on-off sensor for this, I'm on the fence about, I'm not too sure how I would do it just yet, but anyway, let's say you have that sorted. You then run these caps, at that voltage that they're at, through a jewel thief. And you could get away with a much bigger jewel thief. I actually do have, and I have made actually a much bigger jewel thief with, like, well, kind of a large, you know, large ass, you know, coil good size transistors, whatever. Doesn't really matter. Point being, you have that running through a jewel thief, and then you run those to your lights. Because super caps, well, they don't exactly wear out in an average use case, especially if you're discharging once per day. And it doesn't matter if it's a large jewel thief, because if you go back to my DIY videos, I was showing off the screaming jewel thief, as I called it, which was that exact gigantic, like, or upscaled size jewel thief, with the coil being so big, the oscillation is now in human hearing, so it screams. And with different loads, you get different frequencies of the coil, so it makes different sounds. Like I said, go back to that playlist and have a look if you want to know what the fuck am I talking about with that. Which is actually one disadvantage of making a big Jewel Thief. I know Jewel Thieves are not exactly efficient, but they can take a supercap's voltage, and if you're just running LEDs, like in this case, a daisy chain string of lights, I think it would work. In all fairness, and you know, if it would just be a rather simple thing, it would pretty much run itself. You wouldn't have to worry about, you know, these things exactly, you know, wearing out. It's not like, you know, I do actually have down there, just the end of my finger there, I do have some standard solar lights still, which are not actually connected to anything specific. They're actually just, you know, they're running on their own internal system, power system, their own solar panel and shit. But you know, and these were in the, I think those were initially going to be hooked up to the system. Hold on a moment. Apologies for that. That was the postman at the door. But anyway, I think I'm just going to wrap this video up here because I've been talking for just under 16 minutes about this. But you can sort of see roughly what I've done with the solar grid. It's not exactly just solar lights anymore. That was the original intention, and now it's just a small scale, you know, power storage from the sun, and I'm basically charging my USB devices off of it at present. I would like to upscale it, but I'm not sure I'll be able to do so. But supercaps, I am still partly fascinated by, and I'm going to continue work and do some more stuff with them. I might see, depending on price, and I might have to go down AliExpress to find some parts that I need. But I'm thinking of making some supercapacitor actual packs, so around the same voltage or close enough to that, you know, that pack is, and then trying maybe firstly making some kind of power bank kind of thing out of caps. I'm not sure yet. I need to sort of figure out a good sort of pairing of caps, or more importantly, finding a way to boost these the voltage of these things up, because caps, they discharge linearly, and you know their voltage will just keep going down and down and down. It's not like batteries where it's pretty constant, and then it just falls off. So, you know, and I actually do have a very small 16-volt pack, which I'm actually tempted just to hook in line with these, with the batteries at the moment, just to see what that does. But anyway, I'm going to shut up, because I think you've all seen the rain out of my window for long enough. Not to mention, my phone's about to overheat by the look of it, because it's getting fucking hot as I'm holding it. So anyway, yes, let me know what you think of all this random stuff I've already mentioned down below in the comments. Like I said, if you know something that I don't with the car battery that I'm using, and I'm doing something horrendously wrong to it, and I should be crucified for battery abuse, then let me know in the comments, although don't try to crucify me, because I can do that myself. Anyway, yes, but like I said, I'll keep you guys posted if I upgrade anything else. I would have gone outside and shown you a bit closer the lights, but, well, you can probably hear and see the fact that it's raining, and like I said, I hate the rain. Well, I like the smell of the rain, and I hate being out in the rain. So yeah, like I said, let me know those things down below in the comments. Link to my Discord is in the description as always, and you'll know the drill by now. So, thank you for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video.